withdrawal from Hebron is bad for the Jews. Hebron is in danger. Those stones are from the Herodian period, some 2,000 years ago. What other people has such a monument? No other people possesses such a monument. Nothing like it exists. The founders of the people, all buried together in one common place from thousands of years ago. Here are our roots. The Oslo and Cairo agreements stipulated a totally illogical dividing line, separating the Jewish area of Hebron, situated in the valley, from the territory to be controlled by the Palestinian Authority and its soldiers deployed in the surrounding hills. The line cuts through yards, homes, booths, and access paths, and enables the enemy to open fire on every Jewish house and every Jew at point-blank range. As the map indicates, Aharon Gross Square will be only 30 meters away from the enemy. The Arabs will entrench themselves on the surrounding hills that will serve as a base for all anti-Jewish activity in the city of Hebron. Will these buses be able to travel freely on the only road to Jerusalem? Will children continue to play? Will this young girl still be smiling? This boy still laughing? Or will they be in constant danger? Will girls of Hebron continue to build sandcastles to laugh and play? Will hundreds of thousands of Jews continue to come to Hebron? When children of Beit Hadassah play basketball at the foot of Hartashech Hill, exposed to gun or RPG fire from above, will the game go on? Will Jews keep coming to the cave of Machpelah? Senior reserve officers, experts in military tactics who know Hebron well, toured Abu Snena Hill, slated to be handed over to the Arabs. Here, they discussed the security of Hebron. I believe that this agreement is doomed to failure from the outset, insofar as Hebron is concerned. Not only does it fail to provide security for the Jewish community, but it actually endangers its survival in several ways. First, it forces the army to stay close to Jewish homes, effectively stifling the Jewish community, hampering its development, constraining its movements. We have already heard that they want Jewish residents to travel in shielded vehicles and to use reinforced glass for the windows of their homes. They want to build a kind of corridor surrounded by concrete walls up to the cave of Machpelah with a meshed roof to protect from incendiary bombs. It is inconceivable for the interim agreement between the Palestinian Authority and the State of Israel to turn an entire community into a bunker. This was not the purpose of the agreement. This was to be a reciprocal agreement, enabling normal, peaceful life and coexistence. The situation is a delicate one, but the objective is coexistence for peace between the Jews and the Arabs. As you can see, the entire vicinity of the Jewish community of Hebron and the cave of Machpelah is situated on low ground, surrounded by hills. We are now standing on one of those hills that controls the entire area around us. The whole Jewish area will be vulnerable to attacks from all the high ground that the IDF evacuates. Today, for example, there are thousands of people at the cave of Machpelah, and the IDF made sure to have an observation post here to ensure that no harm befalls them. The IDF still holds Abu Snena Hill now, but soon it could be handed over to Arafat's terrorists or those of Hamas and Jibril, who are liable to perpetrate another slaughter of the Jews, as the Arabs did in 1929.
Thank you.
Important to hold on to these places. Important and also feasible. All Israeli leaders realize that the IDF must not pull out of Hebron, because Hebron is full of Hamas sympathizers and the home of the most despicable of all terrorists. Hassan Salameh, who masterminded and commanded attacks on buses in Jerusalem and Tel Aviv, attacks which killed 45 Israelis and wounded 200. Was shot and captured by Israeli soldiers in a part of Hebron from which the IDF was due to withdraw according to the agreement. Had he not been caught, he might have had another bus blown up in Jerusalem or Tel Aviv. Although I am not a religious Jew, I realize when you deny your ancestors, you're left without roots, and then you become like chaff in the wind. True, we're not talking about leaving Hebron, but only about an IDF redeployment. In my estimation, however, an IDF pullout from Hebron in the long run means abandoning Hebron, because it will be impossible to defend the Jewish community. Moreover, I would never want to be in a situation in which we cannot prevent attacks against Jews, but only pursue their murderers, heaven forfend, once the attack has already been perpetrated. Today, Hebron is the last barrier before Jerusalem. This must be emphasized, because if we leave the tombs of our ancestors, what will we be able to say when challenged about Jerusalem? The Jewish people and the Israel government identify with Hebron. A secure Hebron is good for the Jews.